good day, and I'm really grateful and happy and joyful to have this opportunity to talk with you and to be the part of the Hague Talks. This is because I do believe in democratization through conversation, through sharing, through talks. And another reason for that is because of this topic, because really my experience is from a peace activist position that I would even put this title or question of topic today a little bit different, which would be, could we imagine sustainable peace without local governance? Good. It is really not possible. I would like to share with you, but if something, but if I would be too long, please give me some sign with some question or something like that.
Yes.
So, thank you. Then I'm more secure to talk. In a few days, I start my peace work or journey some 30 years ago when a war started in Croatia. So, and I think the really beginning of this part was wakening up my eyes when I realized actually looking around me how violence is spreading so quickly all around me. When I realized that probably, not probably, that for sure, I have a part of responsibility for this war because of my passivity. I was very passive in politics. No politics for me. I am a medical doctor, and I was very happy just to do my work without having anything with policy. And now, after when I realized that, I almost jump in anti-war activism, but it was not realistic. And very soon, because I didn't stay alone, we talked a lot about situation, and we realized that we can't stop the war. That we also probably will not come to influence the direction of the war. But what we would like to do, and we were thinking about, what can we do today in the middle of the war for the future? And we start with imagination of the future society, which kind of society we would like to have. And it was society more resistant to violence and society with much more capacity for non-violent dealing with the problems. That is our imagination. And then we start to think, but what can I do, I can do, or we as a group can do today in the middle of the war for this to reach this our imagination of future society. And a lot of things we find out is possible to do, but always we were very open for cooperation and ask for cooperation and support of our local government. And it was not by chance, but our strategy for that. And I think that the region from which I am coming, or where I am sitting now, is very good example how cooperation between citizens, civil society, local government, and national, but also international supporters could contribute to the peace building. So in our region, the end of the war in Croatia ended by peaceful process. It was one of the most successful UN peace mission, peaceful reintegration of this eastern part, this is country part of Croatia. And during this period, I was coordinating a huge number of young people. We had 10 multi-ethnic peace teams staying together and living together with the people in war-torn local communities. We were doing prevention of conflict, opening communication between two sides, then really building a space for cooperation. And the end, after the 5-6 years, we ended up this process with participatory planning of the common future for each local community. Another project, the name of this project was building a democratic society based on the culture of nonviolence.
This is
I'm
here with the little slide. Ask me for the little
Okay. So I will just end. I will just end with sentence or two sentences. Yeah. That from this my experience, I am very convinced that compassion, solidarity, and cooperation is the way how we can change, do transformation in conflict situation and also in peaceful situation as we have today, and needs for transformation, particularly because we are in the situation of threats of climate, of very vulnerable economy, social and ecological insecurity. Local answers will be a key for the secure future of us, I would say. So, thank you.